What's up YouTube? It's your boy Class G, and now we're back with another video. And for this video, our topic is the story of the white chocolate. And if you are really an NBA fan, you should probably know who white chocolate is, and he is Jason Williams. And before we really get into the main topic, let me just remind you that you should subscribe and smash the like button and click the notification bell so you'll be stay tuned for more banger. As I always say, let's get it on. Jason Williams is a point guard that played for several teams like the Sacramento Kings, Memphis Grizzlies, Miami Heat, and the Orlando Magic, and invented the famous elbow pass that will make you say,
whoa, 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 whoa.
Jason Williams is born in Belle, West Virginia, and the family live on the grounds of DuPont High School. Jason's father, Terry, was a state trooper and had the keys to the gym. Jason took advantage whenever possible. When he was just 4, he was already a ball handler. And by age 7, he had determined that he would become an NBA player someday. Jason was gifted in every sport he tried. He pitched in sandlot baseball games and played quarterback on the same fields come the ball. But basketball is what really stood up for the white chocolate. Jason became the star of the DuPont basketball team in 1990 to 1991 in his freshman year. He teamed up with his classmate Randy Moss for some memorable alley-oops. Moss had his own issues with the authority, but he and Jason became good friends, and they drew hundreds of fans on game nights, forcing the school to install temporary bleachers to accommodate the overflow crowds. On the gridiron, it was the same story. Jason passed and Moss caught, and DuPont proved a formidable opponent during the 1992 and 1993 seasons. At the end of the 1993 to 1994 season, Jason was named USA Today West Virginia Player of the Year while averaging an 18.10 assist average. He and Moss took DuPont to the state championship game where they lost. Still, Jason became the only player in his school history to net more than 1,000 career points. He also handed out more than 500 assists in 4 varsity seasons. Jason's dad suggested that he explore the possibilities at Division II Marshall in West Virginia. He had met Billy Donovan there and was impressed by the young coach, who offered Jason a chance to play after redshirting the 1994-95 season. During the 1995-96, the freshman, now 20, averaged 13.4 points and 6.4 assists for the Thundering Herd. After Donovan accepted a job at the University of Florida, Jason decided to follow him there. He sat out the 1996-1997 season as a transfer, practicing with the team and concentrating on his studies. In 1997-1998, Jason won the starting point guard job for the Gators and played great, averaging 17.1 points and 6.7 assists against the top-flight college competition. His darting, spinning drives, reckless penetration, impossible behind-the-back passes, majestic three-pointers, and uncanny showmanship brought fans out of their seats again and again, even in opponents' arenas. Many compared him to another SEC legend, Pete Maravich. College just wasn't for Jason. That spring, at age 22, he declared himself eligible for the NBA draft. Most pro teams, or specifically NBA teams, refused to consider Jason. The Sacramento Kings was in search of a point guard, overlook his faults, and snag him with the 7th overall pick. Jason went through a difficult rookie year under Rick Adelman. Despite his difficult adjustment to life in the NBA, Jason led the team with 299 assists in the 1999 season, and the Kings finished with a good, not bad, but not great, 27 wins and 23 loss record. Sacramento's year ended in the playoffs with a 99-92 overtime loss to Utah Jazz in the deciding game of the first round. The NBA made Jason Williams his nickname, and that is white chocolate. He became one of the league's most widely known. His jerseys sold like crazy, and the behind-the-back pass enjoyed a revival throughout the NBA. Jason played 2 more seasons with the Kings, along with Chris Webber, Peja Stojakovic, and Vlade Divac. Sacramento won 44 games in 1999-2000, but bowed to the Los Angeles Lakers in the first round of the playoffs. In 2000-2001, the Kings won 55 times. There were more ups and downs in Memphis, but Jason played decent ball for Sidney Lowe. He averaged a career-high 14.8 points and added 8 assists per game. Midway through Jason's second season for Memphis, Hubby Brown took over as a coach. As a TV analyst, Brown had frequently criticized Jason's play, although the relationship, it eventually turned toxic, clashed often with Jason. Because of the confrontations, General Manager Jerry West realized he had to find Jason a new home. On the date August 2005, Miami agreed to the deal as part of a 5-team, 11-player trade that also brought James Posey to the Heat. He played in Miami alternating with Gary Payton at the point and getting the ball to Wade and O'Neal. In his part-time role, he averaged 12.3 points and 4.9 assists. Jason went into the playoffs fresh after being sidelined the final 8 games of the regular season with tendonitis in his right knee. Riley used him judiciously during the postseason and he contributed to the cause in every game. As Miami cruised through 4 series to win its first NBA crown, Jason averaged 9.3 points and 3.9 assists and played with terrific consistency in series wins over the Chicago Bulls, New Jersey Nets, Detroit Pistons, and Dallas Mavericks. To go from trash heap to the pinnacle of basketball in one season was something not even he could have imagined. Although Jason will never be crowned Mr. Consistency, those who have known him over the years will attest to his one unwavering goal, is to win a championship ring. Now, of course, he wants another, but that's for another video.